On this trip, I traveled in Fukuoka and Kumamoto prefectures in Kyushu Island by public transport. I visited a famous shrine and hot spring resort and experienced popular tourist train during the 4-day trip. The first stop is Dazaifu Tenmangu Shrine. It is located about 15 kilometers southeast of Fukuoka City. It's easily accessed by train or bus. If you're catching a train, you get off at Dazaifu Station. It's just 5 minutes walk to get to the shrine from the station, and it has more than 10 million visitors a year. On the way to the shrine from the station, there are many shops like souvenir shops or cafes. It's very pleasant. After browsing the shops, you continue to walk. As you get closer to the shrine, you see a pond. You cross this pond over the three bridges, which represent past, present, and future. This is the main hall of Dazaifu Tenmangu Shrine. People are queuing up for praying. It enshrines the deity of learning, so that many students visit here to pray for success in their upcoming exams. The shops around the main hall sell a wide range of good luck charms, such as educational-related charms, which are supposed to help students to pass exams. When I was a student, I came here and bought a charm too. There are roughly 6,000 plum blossom trees in Dazaifu Tenmangu. And the best season to see the flower is mid-February to early March. I came here in mid-February, so it was just right time to see such beautiful flowers. It was a very pleasant visit here. I'm staying at the hotel in Fukuoka City tonight, and heading for an onsen area by bus tomorrow. Looking forward to it. On the second day, I got an express bus from Fukuoka City to Kurokawa Onsen in Kumamoto Prefecture. It takes about 2 hours and 40 minutes by bus. Kurokawa Onsen is one of the popular hot springs in Kyushu Island. It is not an overly commercialized onsen town, and it doesn't have any large modern hotels or convenience stores. It maintains the traditional look, feel, and atmosphere of the original town. As you stroll around the town, you see many onsen ryokans, attractive shops, cafes, and the bridges that lead to ryokan's entrances over the river. The views from the bridges are fantastic. If you visit Kurokawa Onsens, regardless of whether it's staying for a night or not, you should try different onsens. Kurokawa Onsen Ryokan Association created an onsen token system, which allows visitors to enjoy up to 3 different onsens for 1300 yen. If you're planning to take a bath in 3 onsens, it's definitely better to get the token. After walking for some time, I popped in one of the onsen ryokans, Yama no Yu, which offers a day use onsen. It's a nice open-air bath. They don't have a shower, but they do have shampoo, conditioner, and body soap. Luckily, I was the only customer at the time, and had a very quiet and relaxing moment. After exploring the town, I headed for the tonight's accommodation, Tairoukan. The reason why I chose this ryokan is because it has 8 private onsens. Also, I heard meals they offer are good. This is my room. It seems to have been renovated not long ago. It is very clean and a cozy room with tatami floors. The dinner will be served in this room too, as I have some time before dinner. I'm going to take a bath. Except one, all the onsens are actually located in another building, but it's only 1 minute walk away. Each onsen is separated and completely private. You just choose the one you want to take. Each door has a name on the onsen and a wooden signboard saying either vacant or occupied. This was the first one I tried. It's a really big open air bath. Probably 4 or 5 people can take a bath at once. Because it's open air, I can enjoy the view while taking a bath, although the view was just okay. I did lots of walking today, so it was the absolutely relaxing moment. But I didn't want to stay here long as I wanted to try other onsens. Let's check the next one. The next one is much smaller than the last one, but cozy and has more Japanese atmosphere. The bath is made of rocks and I love the window design. I actually felt more comfortable in the smaller bath. The last one is another cozy bath with the same window design, but the bath is made of wood. The natural light is coming through the gap in the roof, creating a very warm and peaceful atmosphere. After enjoying the onsens, I sat down at the lobby area to cool down my body and went back to my room for dinner. The dinner was brought to the room by the staff and he explained each dish for me. It was absolutely gorgeous. Many good ryokans serve meals in customers' rooms, but such ryokans are usually more expensive to stay. I don't want to spend a fortune, but sometimes I want to have a luxurious moment treating myself. And the staff brought more food. I had just finished half of the first serving. Then, when I was just about to finish the second serving, more food was served. I was nearly full by this time. They brought wagyu beef, grilled fish, and a bowl of rice. I cooked the beef on the small hot plate like a mini barbecue. It was absolutely beautiful and one of the best meals I have ever had in ryokans. On the third day, after spending some time in Kurokawa Onsen, I got an express bus to Kumamoto Prefecture. It takes about 2 hours and 40 minutes. I'm going to catch a popular tourist train next day. I'm super excited! On the fourth day, the last day of this trip, I took a popular tourist train called A Train from Kumamoto Station. A Train has two beautiful gold and black carriages, which make the whole train look very luxurious. It runs between Kumamoto and Misumi stations, operating 3 trains to each direction. But it doesn't run every day. Also, all seats are reserved, so you need to book a seat beforehand. Check their website. The train has a bar counter where you can purchase soft drinks or alcoholic drinks and sit down and relax, looking at the beautiful stained glasses with background jazz music. The second carriage has window-facing kids' chairs and a sofa that anyone can use, along with more passenger seats. I thought about buying an alcoholic drink, but it was still 10:30 in the morning, so I just purchased a coffee at the bar. It takes 50 minutes to get to Misumi Station, so you have plenty of time to enjoy your drink and relax on the train. The train runs along the coastline on the way to Misumi. You can enjoy the view of the Ariake Sea. From Misumi Station, I hired a bicycle to further travel to Misumi Westport, which is about 2.5 kilometers away. Misumi Westport is located in the southwest of Kumamoto City. It is a historic port built in 1884. The port was used as a major shipping point for coal, along with rice, wheat, and flour at the time. In 2015, it became the World Heritage as a major site of Japan's Meiji Industrial Revolution. The preserved or restored old buildings such as ryokan, offices, and courthouse are open to the public. You can walk in and explore them for free. There are also a cafe, a restaurant, and a small souvenir shop. I came back to Misumi Station and found an interesting building nearby, so I popped in to check it out. It's called Pyramid of the Sea. It looks more like a seashell to me, but it's actually a ferry terminal. You can walk up inside the building to the top observation deck. The view from here was pretty good. It was actually good to visit here to fit in time to the next train back to Kumamoto Station. It's time to go home! It was an exciting 4-day trip. Once again, I was lucky to have such a nice weather every single day. I really enjoyed onsens this time. It was so relaxing. I was so impressed with the meals provided in the ryokan. Looking forward to our next trip. Thank you for watching.